Hi folks, how you doing? RussellTrueResults303.com. Check out the website. Link in the description box. Mind, body, spirit, fitness. Putting the healing back in health. Don't forget, once again, I got the podcast up now. Right now it's on Stitcher, TuneIn Radio, and there's one more I can't remember. But I'm slowly getting it on more of these podcast players. I'm working on it, all right? Once again, visit that website, sign up for the newsletter, check out the free gifts button there, got a couple downloads. And once again, just share these videos with someone that you know, if it's useful information, or someone that you know could benefit from it. And this one I'm coming at you with, the man cave, right? This is a big concept nowadays, the man cave. What is a man cave? What should be in your man cave? What is a man truly about, right? So, what is a man cave, I guess? You know, like I said, that's where a man will retreat, where he will go on the weekend. And for most people, it's going to be to play sports, watch sports, play video games. To tell you the truth, I don't even know why grown men play video games. But hey, more power to you. I'm not a video gamer. I haven't been a video gamer since probably about high school. I mean, I played every once in a while. My buddies were, at that point in my life, I was just wasting a lot of time drinking and boozing it up and watching them play video games, you know. I tried to play video games. It's just, it's rare. I definitely don't have a gaming system nowadays. Like I said, I'm a grown man, and I'm a firm believer kind of what the Bible says, you know. When you were a child, you spoke as a child. You know, I taught you as a child. You acted like a child. Now that you're a grown-up, what are you doing? You know, I got to make a video on that. I'm glad I brought that up. I don't have that on my list of ideas. But, so what is a man cave, right? What does your man cave look like? What's your dream man cave look like? Let's pause real quick and think about that. What does your dream man cave look like? Got it? You got that man cave? All right, now throw it all out the window because it's wrong. Well, some of you might be right. But for the most part, I'm going to say you're probably wrong. And it just depends on the man as well. But once again, I have a couple videos, and part of my voice, I'm dealing with a cold right now. But, you know, we have this lost concept of what a man is. And unfortunately, it's tearing society apart. It's tearing families apart on what is a man cave, or, you know, what a man is. And I think it kind of boils over into what your man cave is. You know, a lot of people see it as gotta have the biggest TV, the best video games, what, you know, pictures of women on the wall and bikinis and athletes and sports athletes and this and that. And I think that's just a horrible concept for a man cave, and I apologize if right now you feel offended. But as my boy D1 said in one of his freestyles, for those who get offended, then I am talking to you. You know, those are the people that I'm really talking to. If it offends you, hopefully it's going to spark something in your mind that'll hopefully help you change something. You know, that's what it's truly about. You know, it's kind of like they say, the truth hurts. So what should a man cave be like, in my opinion? Right, I think it's what a lot of man caves are missing. You can see here, I got my small bookshelf right here. This is more of my self-help and spiritual books that I've read. I've read all of them. Down here, I've got books I haven't read. And then in my room, alright folks, how you doing? I just wanted to interrupt this video to say once again, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. And just remember, if these are those motivational videos or something about setting goals, you need to actually take action. All right, don't just flip to the next video. As much as I want a view, or, you know, I want you to share these videos with people, I really want this video to touch you and help change you. So to tell you the truth, when this video is over, kind of don't let it skip to the next video. Don't look at the next video and just pause and kind of soak it in. If you have to, once again, get a pen and paper, write down some thoughts about the video, and kind of just go over it in your mind and see how you can apply it to everyday life. But once again, I just want to say thank you for watching. Don't forget to visit the website, download those free gifts, sign up for the newsletter, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to look up the podcast, True Results 303, at Stitcher and SoundCloud. All right, back to your regularly scheduled program. Sorry, I got a text message. Hopefully you guys can't see that. But and in my room, that's where all my nutrition ones are. So that's up on that shelf there. So I kind of spread them out so I know where to go so I'm not digging through a bunch. But personally, does your man cave have books in it? I mean, that's the main thing. Does it have books? I think every man cave is. And I'm not talking about a Hot Rod magazine or Sports Illustrated magazine. I mean knowledge, wisdom, books, right? Like I said, I've done some videos on this, The Irresistible Revolution. This one I just bought because it sounded interesting. Belize, The Retirement Guide. No wonder they call him a savior. Why we can't stay silent. I mean, that's all here. I've done, you know, The Einstein Factor. I've done videos on some of those books. But I mean, does your man cave have books? You know, I think a man cave should be a place where you can go to get some peace and quiet. Unfortunately, the world is so noisy and prevents us from getting to know our inner self and to know God or the spirit or whatever you want to call him. And you go to your man cave and you just blare music and you watch more TV and you don't give yourself time to rest, relax, recover, recuperate, grow stronger mentally. And it's hurting us, man. You need to be quiet. You need to slow down. Give you a place of some peace and quiet. Not just to go there and be even more self-destructive and do things that are preventing you from being what you want to be. So for me, it's going to be books is number one. Does your man cave have books in it? Knowledge, biographies, autobiographies, spirituality, self-help, poems. I've got this one right here. I've done some, just if you follow me on Twitter and stuff, I try to do all motivational and inspirational quotes, and I've gotten a lot from that book. I'm not a poem guy, but I'm working on it. Is there a place where you can write? Do you have a book where you can just journal your thoughts? I think that's something that we need to do. You know, you need to get in touch with yourself. I'm sorry. You know, men, we need to learn to be a little bit more emotional. Unfortunately for me, I'm not that way, but I'm working on it. You know, it should be something along the same lines as, you know, maybe it's just a whiteboard or a chalkboard where you can brainstorm ideas. You know, I have videos on why Sunday is the most important day of the week. It's kind of your game plan day. You know, Sunday, you should retreat to your man cave and be like, hey, what's my game plan this day? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. What are the kids doing? What is the wife doing? Am I giving myself, one-on-one time with every single one of my children, with my wife? Do we have a date for me and my wife? Are there specific activities that the children are participating in that you need to fit into your schedule? So we're not stressed out because the day comes and we don't have a plan, right? So Sunday is game day. You know, it's game preparation for the man. So retreat to your man cave and prepare for your week. What are you doing to better yourself and those around you, right? Next, I'm going to say some form of exercise equipment. You know, I've made videos on how to install a TRX in your garage. If you have a man cave, you can do it in your man cave too. It's simple. You find the floor joists, or since I'm on the side, I don't have a man cave. I don't have an extra room. I just have this room. That's why for me, the man cave is the garage. For some of you men, it's the garage too. Put a book in your garage. You know what I mean? Just get a 2x6. Bolt it to every single stud, 2 screws, put an eye bolt in there. The TRX or the knockoff TRX has a carabiner. You just snap it in, boom. Home gym. That's all you really need for a home gym is a TRX, a suspension trainer. The one I got is from Walmart, $40. You should have some form of exercise equipment in there. And like I said, for me, you have the spiritual books. It's somewhere you should go to pray and just be quiet. You know, you can do board games, a chess board, something that's going to stimulate you mentally as well and challenge you. So some form of a game. I prefer chess. I used to play a lot of chess. I don't as much now. I should probably get into it. But chess, you know. And then this is, once again, this is a quiet time where you can use the man cave. You know, when we have the man cave, it's usually no children allowed. Get out of here. This is where you should be able to bring your child in and kind of mentor them and talk to them. You know, and get to know your children. So see, nowadays children don't even go outside anymore anyways. So it's time for you to connect with your children. Right? So, like I said, there's some basics. There's a lot of other things that you could probably put in there. For me, once again, it's just making it a positive environment. And making it an environment that's going to help you grow mentally, spiritually, and physically. All right? And it's, you know, it could be a bonding time for men. Get to know your friends. Bring your friends in. Kind of turn things off. I think we need to stop bonding over sports and things like that, because unfortunately when we do that, I know for my friends aren't very emotional. It's like me, it's kind of ingrained in me because my friends aren't very emotional anymore, or you know, at all. I think now that I've grown in the journey that I'm on, I'm more of a spiritual person and I've become more of an emotional person. So for me trying to be emotional with them, I think they see it as kind of weird. But some of them are, you know, they're starting to open up to me. But once again, it's just being the person that is going to actually start the conversation. And I've been trying to do that more with the friends that are accepting of it. Some of them aren't. But, you know, hopefully when they're talking to the other friends, they'll be able to have a deeper conversation than just all this superficial BS that's out there. So, there you have it. Man cave must haves. If your man cave does not have these things in it, then your man cave sucks, in my opinion. All right? So I hope that helps. Subscribe to the channel. Share and like these videos.